I've been reading and watching reviews of the PlayStation Access Controller, which is an accessibility-oriented controller for the PlayStation 5, and some of the reviewers are saying, this works great on my PS5, I wish it also worked on my PC. Which is weird, because in my experience, it works perfectly fine on a PC. Let me show you. I have the controller currently configured so that the button mapping matches the labels that are on the controller. Let's go to my PC. This is a perfectly normal PC running Windows 10. I didn't install any drivers or special software to make this work. Let's first open JoyCPL, which is a built-in utility to test controllers in Windows. And as you can see, the joystick is working. The buttons are working. Let's open a gamepad testing website in the browser. The joystick is also working. Here it's a bit weird because the button mapping is not entirely correct. The face buttons are in a weird order, but this is not a problem specific to the Access controller. Unfortunately, a lot of controllers have this problem here. Let's try Steam. This is the controller settings screen in Steam. As you can see, it detected the controller as a DualSense wireless controller, which is not entirely correct, but close enough. We can test the inputs here. The joystick is working. The buttons are working as expected. They even are mapped correctly. So let's try a game. Let's open Tekken 7. I have to navigate the menu using my keyboard because I don't have anything mapped to the D-pad on the PlayStation Access controller, and the stick doesn't work in the menu for some reason. If we go to the button configuration screen, check button input. As you can see, the joystick works. The buttons work and they are configured correctly. The mapping is matching what's configured on the controller. So yeah, in my experience, it's working as expected. Let me show you one more thing. On the PlayStation 5, you can edit the profiles on this controller. You can remap the buttons, and you cannot do it from a PC, but the profiles still work. If you press the profile button, it still switches the profiles, even though the lights on the controller don't reflect that. So on my PlayStation 5, I set profile 3 to be mostly the triangle button. Let's see how that works in Tekken. If I press the profile button twice, I will be on profile 3. And now most of the buttons are the triangle button. If I press the profile button again, I should be back on profile 1. And now the buttons work as previously. So yeah, the only caveat is that the lights here don't work, but the profile button works. Keep in mind that if you're using two Access controllers on your PS5, or if you're using an Access controller together with a DualSense controller, your setup might not translate directly to the PC, because when you connect multiple controllers to a PC, they will be seen as multiple controllers. They will not be seen as one controller like on the PS5. So depending on what game you want to play, this might be a problem. For example, flight simulators typically don't have a problem with using multiple controllers, but fighting games like Tekken typically assume every player uses a single controller. So if that's your setup, you might need some additional software or hardware solutions. So yeah, keep that in mind.